Hello, beautiful people. So as Easter approaches, I remember to make the date cookies that I love. And this time I'm making the traditional recipe with flour and just a little bit of farina, because sometimes I make it with all farina rather than flour. And so I used the, like the coffee mug to measure, as you can see, which is about 1.5 measuring cups. And I added 10 cups of those flour, 1 cup of farina, and 1 cup of dried milk, powdered milk. And then I had all the seeds that I wanna add. So there's the mihlib that I'm adding. So I grind it and add 2 tablespoons. And then I have the anise. I also grind and add 4 tablespoons of that. The fennel seeds, I add 4 ground tablespoons of that. Black seed, أو حبت البركة or جزحة, 4 tablespoons. Sesame, I toasted the sesame over the stove and then added the toasted sesame, 1 cup also. And then I added 1 tablespoon of yeast, as you can see, and 1 cup of powdered sugar. And I mixed all the dry ingredients together before I add the shortening, which is clarified butter and olive oil. So I melted 2 cups of the clarified butter that I make at home and added those 2 cups to the dried ingredients. And then I added 1 cup of olive oil. I used extra virgin olive oil, which as you can see is a little bit darker in color. And I think that's what gives a little bit of dark color to the cookies, but it's so good. So I mix them all together before I start adding the water, the warm water, just to reach the consistency I want. This kneading process takes a while because I made so much. I kept working with it for at least 15 minutes. Then I'm adding warm water to it. I added about 2 cups of those. But just keep adding a little by little until you reach the consistency you want that makes it easy to work with. So after I'm done kneading, I cover it and start working on the dates. I have cleaned the dates, took the pit out and the tip, made sure went one by one, made sure they don't have any pits, and then I would chop them and make them as a paste in the food processor. Add a little bit of nutmeg and cinnamon to it. So there's some of the dates. This is 1/3 of them because I made 6 pounds and I just chop them a little bit to make it easier on the food processor to work and make it a paste. Forgot to say, other than the nutmeg and cinnamon, I added 1 tablespoon of ghee just to make it easier to work with and not stick to my hands. And I made it look like ropes so I can stuff it inside the cookie. So I take each piece of cookie, of the dough, and roll it to make it even, and then kind of run through it to make a dent in it, like so, and add the rope of dates to it. Sometimes I don't make them thin enough, so I make sure I adjust it to the size of the dough and then close it as such. And after that, I roll it again to make everything, to make sure everything is even, and I cut it to the desired size. And then roll it to make it look like a bracelet. Actually, some people call it bracelet cookies. So I close the ends together to make it round. I have already preheated the oven to 450 degrees and I will bake them, put them on a cookie sheet lined with parchment paper and bake them for about 15 minutes until they're light golden brown. And my youngest beautiful grandchildren will do the taste test, as you will see.
God, This is so good. You should try this. Really, really good.
Yum.
Look at the video at Camellia's channel. There's a video about these where she makes them. Yeah, and they're really good. You should try it. Date cookies.
Kake bajwa. You say kake bajwa?
Kake bajwa.
Good job.
So much. Like, so much.
Yeah. Grant? Well, enjoy صحتين وعافية and have a happy Easter, everyone.